हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द मैथ्स क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज अ कॉनिक सेक्शंस. लेट्स डिस्कस इट्स ऑब्जेक्टिव फर्स्ट. फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव इज डिफरेंट कॉनिक सेक्शंस. वी विल डू हाउ वी कैन फाइंड डिफरेंट कर्व्स बाय द इंटरसेक्शन. सेकेंड ऑब्जेक्टिव इज parabola and its properties. Third is ellipse and its properties. And the last objective, that is hyperbola and its properties. Today we are going to start with the very first type, that is different conic sections. Then we will complete the second objective, that is parabola and its properties. So conic section means intersection of a plane with the right circular cone. There are three types of curves. So obtained are, first is a parabola, second ellipse, and third is a hyperbola. From the diagram you can see that we are having a double cone. Now this is a plane. When we do the intersection of the cone with the plane, depending upon the direction of the plane, we get the different type of curve. For example, in the first, we are getting this curve. It is of the form parabola. Now, in the second case, when we change the direction of the plane like this, we get a different type of curve like this. It is an ellipse. Next is when we do the intersection of the cone with the plane in this direction, we are getting two curves. These two curves are collectively known as a hyperbola. So in this way, we get three types of curves, that is parabola, ellipse, and hyperbola. Now, today we are going to start with the very first type, that is the parabola and its properties. Now, based on the direction of the curve, we are having four types of parabola. First is a right-handed parabola, second left-handed parabola, third upward parabola, and fourth one is a downward parabola. Now, all these curves are having different equations. First, for right-handed, equation is y square is equal to 4ax. Left-handed, equation is y square is equal to minus 4ax. For upward, equation is x square is equal to 4ay. And for downward parabola, equation is x square is equal to minus 4ay. Now, next property is the vertex. Now, vertex is the starting point of the parabola. So, in figure, this is the starting point. So, it is origin. In all cases, origin is the vertex. So, coordinate of vertex are 0, 0 in all cases. Now, next is axis. Now, axis is a line along which the curve is symmetric. So, in first case, x-axis is the axis. In second, again x-axis but negative x-axis. In third, positive y-axis. And in the fourth, negative y-axis. So, in the first two, it is x-axis. And the last two, it is y-axis. Fifth point is the equation of axis. Now, equation of x-axis is y equal to 0. Similar in the second case also. In third case, axis is y-axis. So, equation is x equal to 0. Similarly, in the fourth case also. Now, next is the focus. Focus is a point on the axis at a fixed distance A. Similarly, in the second, this distance is A. Here this upward distance is A and here it is A. So according to it, coordinates of focus are A, 0. Here it is minus A, 0. Here in third parabola it is 0, A because it lies on the y-axis. In fourth it is 0, minus A. So focus coordinates are A, 0 for the first, minus A, 0, 0, A and 0, minus A. Now next is equation of directrix. Now directrix is a line which is at the same distance at the focus from the vertex. So here if focus is at a distance A, so directrix is also at distance A from the vertex. So from here we can find the equation of this line, that is x is equal to minus A. On shifting minus A on this side we get x plus A is equal to 0. So in this way we can find the equation of directrix in all other cases also. So equation of directrix is x plus A is equal to 0 for right handed parabola. For left handed it is x minus A equal to 0. For upward parabola it is y plus A equal to 0. And for downward parabola y minus A is equal to 0. Now next property is the length of latest rectum. Now first of all let's understand the meaning of latest rectum. Now latest rectum is a line passing through focus and cut the parabola at two points. So LL dash is a latest rectum. So we have to find its length. This length is fixed in all cases. So length of latest rectum is 4A. So it is same in all cases. These are the properties related to the different types of parabola. Now next to some example based on these properties. First example is find the vertex, axis, focus, equation of the directrix and length of the latest rectum of the curve yk is equal to 10x. Now first of all we will identify which parabola is given. According to that we will apply their properties. So here equation is yk is equal to 10x, which is of the form yk is equal to 4ax. So it is a right handed parabola. So we will apply all the results of a right handed parabola. First of all, when you compare these two equations, we get 4a is equal to 10. So from here we can find the value of A, that is 10/4. So after cutting we are getting the value of A, that is 5/2. Now for all curves, as you can see, vertex is 0, 0. So we are applying the result of right hand parabola. So here vertex is 0, 0. Same result I have written here. So next is axis. For right-handed parabola, axis is x-axis. So its equation is y equal to 0. So I have written here, axis is y is equal to 0. Next is the focus. Focus, as you can see here, for right-hand parabola, it is A, 0. Here, put the value of A, so we get 5/2, 0. Next is equation of directrix. X plus A is equal to 0. Put the value of A here. So we get X plus 5/2 is equal to 0. And the last one is a length of latest rectum, that is constant 4a. So here put the value of a, we will get the length of latus rectum is equal to 4 into 5 by 2. Here after cutting we are left with 5 twos are 10. In this way we can apply the properties of the parabola according to the given. Now next example is very, very important, that we have to find the equation of the parabola when focus is given and equation of directrix is given. So let PXY be any point on the parabola. Now here firstly focus is given, second directrix is given. Now you can draw any parabola to solve the question. So like this I have drawn like right handed parabola. So here focus is given minus 1 comma minus 2. P is any point on the curve and this is the directrix. X minus 2y plus 3 is equal to 0. Now in parabola, remember the property, in case of parabola eccentricity is equal to 1. Now eccentricity is a ratio of PF and PM. PF is a distance of the point from the focus and PM is a distance of the point from the directrix. In this case, as E is equal to 1, so when you put the value on cross multiplying, we are getting the result PF is equal to PM. Same property we are going to use to find the equation of the parabola. So for PF, both the points are given, so we can find their distance by using the distance formula. So under root of x plus 1 whole square plus y plus 2 whole square is equal to, now distance of point from the line, here we apply the formula, so it is mod of x minus 2y plus 3 upon under root of 1 square plus minus 2 square, that is the square of the coefficients. Now on solving this one we will get under root of 1 square plus 2 square is equal to 5. Now you are can see their square roots are there. So on for solving square root we will do squaring on both sides. Now on squaring, here square root sign will cancel out and here also square root sign will cancel out. On cross multiplying we are left with 5 multiply x plus 1 whole square plus y plus 2 whole square, and on right hand side we are left with the square of this term. So it is x minus 2y plus 3 whole square. Now apply the identity here. In first one it is a plus b whole square. Similarly same property in the second one also, and in third one it is a plus b plus c whole square. So apply the property. In first case we get 5 into x square plus 2x plus 1 plus y square plus 4y plus 4. And on the right hand side it is a plus b plus c whole square. So answer is x square plus 4y square plus 9 minus 4xy plus 6x minus 12y. Now when we combine the like terms we get here, on firstly solving the bracket then combining the like terms, we get the final equation as 4x square plus 4xy plus y square plus 4x plus 32y plus 16 is equal to 0. This is the required equation of parabola. Now students, I hope you are able to solve sums related to these types given in your SNAP homework. Before starting the work, go through the links guided in the SNAP homework. Rest we will continue in our next class. Thank you.